What's going on, everybody? This is Joe. I'm back here with another draft for you, another bonus Saturday video, as I like to call it. We opened actually a really, really sweet pack. Kefnet's Last Word is really nice. I've gotten to use it once before if you've been following along with the channel. I like Appeal to Authority a lot. It does kind of, it's best with both colors. Sure, you could technically use it if you're just green, but it's working together. This card's amazing. Sifter Worm is also really cool, although very expensive. It kind of just automatically puts us in the ramp deck. I like Kefnet's Last Word, although kind of similar to what we were talking about here. This is dual color, but this is double of the same color. I guess that's the same thing with Sifter Worm, but by the time you get to seven mana, you're probably there anyway. I am going to take Kefnet's Last Word here. Like I said, it doesn't commit us to two colors. Chandra's Defeat is just a sideboard card, and the Bitterbow Sharpshooters is the only common that, like, screams out. Well, Lethal Sting is good as well. But, yeah, Kefnet's Last Word is good, and besides that desert that was there, there wasn't really anything in blue that we were, like, really passing. Torment of Venom is nice here. I like Unquenchable Thirst, too, but I think Banewit Punisher is the best card in this pack. Again, the defeat cards are sideboard at best, and you're going to probably get them pretty late. Unquenchable Thirst is the best if you're playing with deserts, and we don't have any of those yet. We still could. It's still very early on in this draft, but Banewit Punisher is an amazing piece of removal. It does look like we're going more control-y if we're taking Kefnet's Last Word, so Banewit Punisher is a really nice way to go. And if you get other minus one counter cards, it does a good job of helping you out there. So I'm definitely going to go with the Banewit Punisher here. Crypt of the Eternals is just okay, and we do have blue, and if we're picking this, we have black. So if it comes back, we could take it, but it's a filter land, not a regular land for different colors. So it's definitely not a high pick by any means. All right, so we're in blue-black Soulfall. Doomfall is just okay. Obviously, the rare is better. That does this Torment of Hailfire. I like Frilled Sandwalla a lot, although the white in this pack looks good as well. You've got Sunscourge Champion. The gaining life isn't super relevant, although you can tap four and discard a card to get a 2/3. Unconventional Tactics, I haven't gotten a chance to use it yet, and I haven't seen anybody else using it to any effect. So I don't know if it's good or not. Doomfall's okay. Aerial Guide probably is a lot better. Sure, we could be in a control-y deck, but still, Aerial Guide making itself and something else fly when it attacks is very helpful. I've used that to good effect as well. So while Doomfall is tempting, we are also in blue, and Aerial Guide is a great card in that color. So I'm going to take that. We move on to Imaginary Threat. There's another Unconventional Tactics here. That's interesting. Imaginary Threats, I haven't gotten a chance to use yet. There's really nothing. I mean, the deserts are nice, because if you're playing a deck that cares about deserts. Oh, I'm sorry. I missed the Torment of Venom. I'm going to take a Torment of Venom. That card is amazing, where we were talking about good removal. Imaginary Threats, like I said, I haven't gotten a chance to use it yet, and I don't know that this is the deck for that. Because we're not, so far we don't have a lot of good blockers, and you want this if you have a bunch of big blockers that they're not really attacking into, and then you can just block their stuff, make them make bad attacks, block and kill stuff. But speaking of killing stuff, it's a heck of a lot easier to just use a card like this. So yeah, we'll stick with our blue-black and use Torment of Venom. Well, if we're in blue-black, yeah, I mean, the card's not terrible. If you get up to seven mana, it's a recoil. That's like the worst recoil ever. Oasis Ritualist is good, and there's the Green Desert as well. I don't think people, from what I've seen in the last couple of drafts that I've done, it doesn't look like green is being picked very highly, which is unfortunate, but I think I'm going to go with Consigned to Oblivion. It's an uncommon in both of our colors. The bounce effect is nice. If we get an unsummon, it kind of does the same thing. But still, making someone discard two cards, especially at five mana, they would probably only have around two cards in their hand. So if they were saving something, or if they have like a high drop or something like that, we can kind of make them pay. Fraying Sanity, I am a guy who enjoys milling, but not in limited. I just don't see it being useful. All right, so we go on to this one. Kenra Eternal is nice. Very, very nice. Moaning Wall is okay. Tragic Lesson's okay. Without Weakness is okay. But the Kenra Eternal is very good. Sunset Pyramid's not bad, but I wanna be doing other things with my mana. There's another Green Desert and a Harrier Naga, so green's not bad either. It looks like Sultai in general is open based on this pack, and kind of what we've been seeing. But I'll take the Kenra Eternal here. I think it's just a fine creature. A 2-2 for 2, but it also has Afflict 1, so yeah, I'll definitely do that. Liliana's Defeat, like I said, sideboard card at best. There's another Torment of Venom here. I'll definitely take one of those. Scrounger of Souls is not bad. A 5-mana 3-4 lifelinker I like. If neither of those were here, I would still probably do Countervailing Winds over Liliana's Defeat. It's just such a late, maybe not, but it's such a late sideboard card that you'd probably be seeing them much later. But yeah, it's definitely Torment of Venom here. This is a great removal spell. Plus, it does other things on top of it. We just get another Kenra Eternal. Like I said, Crypt of the Eternals is still here. I'd rather be picking up more useful things like a Kenra Eternal at this point. So yeah, I'm going to do that. Cunning Survivor is just bad. As I said it, and then it's just right here anyway. How is this still here? This card is so good. Like, I'm not in those colors, but the card is amazing. Cunning Survivor's bad. Wretched Camel is okay. It's a 2-mana 2-1. We don't have any deserts yet, but, you know, I could take Appeal to Authority, but I'm not double splashing for it. So I think it's just Wretched Camel, even though that makes me really, really sad. There's another Crypt, but there's a Desert and another Kenra Eternal. It could just be Kenra Eternal.deck. Yeah, we don't have anything yet that cares about deserts, and I think Kenra Eternal is a lot nicer of a threat to put on the board as opposed to the Desert with the hopes of getting something else that cares about that later. So another Kenra Eternal. Wow, yeah. I mean, over Doomfall, the problem with cards like these is I am definitely a person who subscribes to the fact that they're just going to choose whatever's worst for you because you're giving, well, sorry, you're going to run into issues with the fact that neither of these is going to be good, and you're going to pick one and it's just not going to be that bad for them. So yeah, I'm going to pick that. I guess I do Imaginary Threats here. It's an uncommon. I said I hadn't gotten a chance to try it, but that doesn't mean I don't want to, so I don't know. I don't really have good blockers, but if it keeps their stuff tapped out and then I win, that would be nice. We'll see. I might not even use it. Seer the Last Tomorrow is the only thing we can play, although we're not going to, so I'll put that in the sideboard. Tragic Lesson we might run. It's not a bad card. We're definitely in the right colors, though. That's for sure. Okay, well, there's another Bane Whip Punisher, there's also another Aerial Guide, there's a Lethal Sting, this pack's pretty sweet for us, there's this, but we're not in green, and so it's a 1-mana Scry 3, which is not terrible, but Bane Whip Punisher is much better. I would even take Aerial Guide over it, I feel like, at this point. Sand Strangler is really good, we're just not in red, but I'm gonna take the Bane Whip Punisher. It's another piece of removal, we're just getting a lot of duplicates, which is nice. So yeah, I'll do that. This is a pretty sweet deck. I don't know that I run this wretched camel, but we'll see. If I don't get enough playables or whatever, then I'll definitely do it. It's not something that I hate. It's just not as good as a lot of the other things that we're doing. Here's the Liliana's Defeat. Like I said, that's sideboard at best. Unquenchable Thirst, but we don't have a lot of deserts yet. So I think it's just Lethal Sting. I mean, removal is important. I don't know if I've mentioned that enough, but I think I'm going to do that over this Lethal Sting. So, or I'm sorry, I'm going to do Lethal Sting over this Unquenchable Thirst. So, yeah. And again, hopefully Liliana's Defeat comes around late, because that's probably what I would take next out of this pack at this point. Because that other Unquenchable Thirst went a little early as well. At least it looked like. I don't think it wheeled. So I can't even necessarily say that if I pick up more deserts now that I'll Definitely get that back. Here's another Doomfall. There's a Vile Manifestation. We don't have a ton of cycling, though. And there's a Lurching Rappi, speaking of things with cycling. This is a 4-2 for 4 as opposed to this 3-mana Doomfall. We saw this Doomfall come around late last time, too, so I think I'll just take the Lurching Rotbeast. Spellweaver Eternal, we're not super heavy on spells. I mean, we've got removal and stuff, and it does have Afflict, but it has one toughness. So if we're playing against anyone that can do anything with minus one counters, it just is gonna die immediately. So yeah, I'm gonna go with the Rot Beast. Hope that the Doomfall wheels, because there's really nothing else in this pack for us. That pack was really good for red though. There's an Aerial Guide. I was gonna say an unsummon, but Aerial Guide's much better. Putting creatures in the air, and with all our removal, we can just kill their things that could block flying, like reach and stuff, and just get in the air and deal some damage. So that seems fine. Yeah, again, there's another Kenra Scrapper in here. There's a Wildfire Eternal, a Magmaroth. Red seems to be kind of open as well, which means that we could have taken those Crypt of the Eternals, but I don't think we need a third color. I think we're doing pretty well without it. If Unsummon comes back, I'm going to take that because I think that's fine. There's a River Hoopoe. That's unfortunate. I would love to have a River Hoopoe. I don't know why this is going around so late. We don't really have any way to splash, which is why I'm not really considering it. There's a Desert, there's a Ruin Rat, and there's a Scrounger of Souls. There's a Striped River Winder as well, but we're. I would probably, out of these, we have enough removal, I feel like, so I don't necessarily need the rat. I can pick up the Scrounger of Souls, and later game, if they've brought us down kind of low, if we're facing like an aggro deck or something, this is a nice card that we can use to start bringing our life total back up again. So I would probably go for a Scrounger of Souls. Our curve is so low to begin with, that, yeah, I think a 5-drop is not the worst thing in the world right now. Okay, we got a foil unsummon. There's another Scrounger of Souls. I would probably take the Scrounger again, hoping for the unsummon to wheel, although I don't know. There will actually only be one card left out of this pack, so I highly doubt it. Because Life Goes On is in here. So yeah, I'm gonna take the Scrounger again as a second 5-drop in a row. But again, our deck seems to want to be lots of duplicates, so we'll just do that. There's a Desert. There's a Liliana's Defeat. There is a Striped River Winder, and there's a Without Weakness. I could go with the River Winder, but I don't know that. Do we need finishers? You know, this is something that works well against targeted removal, but not board wipe removal. Again, Liliana's Defeat being a sideboard card, the Desert being something they don't really need. Maybe I do take a Striped River Winder. We've been padding our the bottom of our curve, so let's see if we can't get some top end stuff. There is another Scrounger. That might be a one too many. There's the Crypt of the Eternals, but we haven't gotten any red. And there's Tragic Lesson. I mean, returning a land we control to our hand with this low of a curve isn't the worst thing in the world, but it does kind of put it puts us behind, and that's not something we really want to be doing. I mean, discarding cards isn't the worst thing in the world, but I might just take a third Scrounger. It's just gonna feel really bad if we have more than one in like our opening hand or something. Although again, our curve is pretty low, so let's try it. Okay, there's another Imaginary Threats, there's a Countervailing Winds, and there's a Grisly Survivor. I guess I'll take the Winds. It would be nice to have a form of counter if they have. I mean, I don't know how many things we're going to have in our graveyard, but if they're playing something that we just kind of can't deal with otherwise, we can put this in because I probably wouldn't run this in the main. All right. Well, there's a Cunning Survivor, another Seer of the Last Tomorrow, and a Spellweaver Eternal. I'll just put this in the sideboard as well. Okay, Doomfall came back, so did Vile Manifestation. There's a Full Art Swamp. I'm gonna take this Doomfall, and I'm gonna try it. I don't know that it's the best choice, but we shall see if it works for us. We might just cut it if we have too many cards. Without weakness would be the only thing that we can play. It's not the worst thing in the world. It might still be a sideboard. We'll see. The River Hoopoe comes back. Why? This card's insane. I'm taking it. If we find a way to splash green, I'm playing that card. There's, I mean, no, doesn't really matter. We're just gonna do that. And a land. Okay. Well, let's see what Amonkhet has for us. Wow. If we can play this Hoopoe, I'm playing this Hoopoe. That card's great. Okay. Do we see this pack right now? This pack's insane. There's black Cartouche, blue Trial, black Trial. This is great. There's Wandering Death as well. That's probably what's coming back out of here for us, because I'm assuming all of these three will be gone. I mean, I'm going to take one of them. And it's probably just going to be black Trial, because if we get another Cartouche at some point, then doing trial shenanigans with making them sack a creature, bouncing it and making them sack a creature seems really good for us. Plus it's a low drop. We like two drops in this deck. And apparently only in black we like two drops in this deck. Wow. Okay, Gravedigger's fantastic. Naga Oracle wouldn't be bad, and I wouldn't be upset with a Blighted Bat. There's a Trial of Zeal here as well, which is insane. But yeah, Gravedigger is an amazing card, and I will take it. Because if one of these, Scrounger of Souls dies, or even if we just bring back a Kenra Eternal, that doesn't feel bad, or a Banewit Punisher after we've sacrificed it to kill something, so Gravedigger is great. I'm liking how this deck is turning out so far. We're getting some pretty sweet stuff. There's another trial. We got lots of trials in these packs. There's a Soul Stinger and a Naga Oracle. I think Naga Oracle is going to be better. It's a way for us to fix our draws coming up. As opposed to a Soul Stinger, which it is a 4/5 for 4. I mean, we've got, three fours, so we don't have anything really big. We've got this 4/2, which maybe I take out the Rot Beast and put in the Soul Stinger instead over the Naga Oracle. There was another Naga Oracle that we saw that I'm hoping comes back, so I'm gonna take this Soul Stinger, like I said, in the hopes that the Oracle wheels from earlier. Wow. How is there a green Cartouche in here still? I haven't been super impressed with Champion, but black Cartouche is great and it's what I'm taking. But green Cartouche is fantastic. We're not in those colors, so it's not what I'm taking. But yeah, I'm gonna take a Cartouche here. Black Cartouche is great, and again with our trial, that's really nice. So yeah, let's do it. Plus, it can give something else that doesn't already have lifelink, lifelink. And it gives things minus one counters, which matters for our Banewit Punishers. There's another trial in Trial of Knowledge and a Wasteland Scorpion. There's a Pitiless Vizier as well, and a Hecma Sentinels and the Evolving Wilds and a Censor. But I'm probably going to take trial. We did just get a Cartouche, and card draw would not be a terrible idea in this deck if we play out our whole hand. If it's all low drops, refilling it seems like it would be very helpful. So let's try that. Wow, double Cartouche, but there's a final reward as well. Wow, we were definitely in the right colors. There is not a question about that. I think I might just take a second Cartouche now that I have two trials over a final reward. We do have a lot of removal, although I don't know that you can ever have too much. But I'm gonna take black Cartouche here. This seems like definitely the way that we want to go. God, I doubt Final Reward wheels. Maybe Blighted Bat does, but oh man. These are great packs for us. Like, really, really good. I don't even know. I mean, we've got 27 cards in our deck now. I think we might just, like, this is really more of a two drop than anything else. Because I don't know that I'd want to be trying to do both at the same time. I don't even know that I would necessarily do Oblivion. I would probably play Consign as like more of a combat trick or something, or to put them behind, and then play Oblivion much later when they only have two cards left in their hand or something. I don't know that I'm playing this Riverwinder. I think I can keep my curve a little lower than that, so I'm gonna put that in the sideboard. There's a this pack's semi for us. I mean, there's Dune Beetle, Compelling Argument's bad, Slither Blade's bad. I'm gonna take the Scorpion. Death Touch is not a bad idea at all, so I'm gonna do that. I'm also gonna do this so we can see all these things, because our 2 and 3 drop slot is insane. Splendid Agony, what? Yeah, I'll definitely take that. That card's nuts. We have to make some real tough cuts out of this deck. I think I'm gonna cut a Scrounger of Souls, because we do have three, and they're pretty high up there. I'll probably cut the Imaginary Threats as well, and there was Doomfall I said I would probably cut as well. Maybe Wretched Camp comes out. Yeah, Amonkhet hooked us up. I wasn't necessarily expecting this much. Wow. Yeah, I mean, over Wander and Death, yes. I'll take a third cartouche with two trials. This is going to be a pretty sick deck. I'm doing that. And the Naga Oracle came back. Like I said, there's a full art land, but I mean, out of everything here, like it's Naga Oracle or Winds of Rebuke, but it's Naga Oracle. Again, helping us fix our draws is pretty important, so. And there's another Naga Oracle. Well, we're not playing both. I don't even know that we're playing one. We'll see if we empty our hands really quickly, then we can consider it. Wow. Yeah, this is going really well. Illusory Wrappings is also going to go on the sideboard. We're obviously heavier black with basically a blue splash at this point. Well, I don't know that we play either, to be honest. But I would probably take the Vizier. Yeah. Do you guys think we were in the right colors? I think we were in the right colors. Scribe of the Mindful goes in the sideboard. If we need to get some of our removal back, we can play it, although I doubt it. I doubt that comes up at all for us. Is this a land or a crappy common that they took a full art over? Just to end this thing off. What are we cutting here? These cards are all great. Maybe I cut the Scorpion. Oh, and a Tragic Lesson. I need one more cut. Yeah, here's a land. That's fine. All right. We need to make one cut. This deck looks fantastic. It's got removal, it's got creatures. It doesn't really have big hitters, but it does have cartouches and trials and stuff, so we can draw into other threats and stuff. So let me do this. Like I said, this is more of a two drop, so we'll put it over there. Our curve is really low. It might be a 16 lander, but I doubt it, especially because we have splash, and within that splash there's one whoops, there's one double colored spell. So yeah, I'm not exactly sure. I can always start with 16 and then go, move to do add a 17th and get rid of something else if I need. It's a real shame that we can't play this Hoopoo. This card's great. Let's see what it recommends for lands. Four seems a little low, because we have what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 blue mana symbols. So yeah, I'm gonna do 5 and 11, and see how that works for us. I assume that we're gonna need more blue later, but we shall see. I'm gonna save this deck, and I will be back in a second with round one. Here we go. We are starting round one, and we get to go first. We're playing Mini Taro, I guess. This is an interesting hand. We can give a cartouche to an aerial guide, and we have one piece of removal. It's definitely not the best. We have no two drops out of the millions that we have, but it's better than mulliganing, so we're gonna keep it. They are deciding still. They did not go to six. All right, so we're gonna start with an island and then we're going to pass. Oh, they sent us a message. Oh. Very good. Good sports. Okay, that'll be it. That's fine. Okay, we can still do nothing on two, so that's it for us. White black. All right, that's a thing. But that's the end of their turn, which means we get the first play with an aerial guide. They could have removal for it, I guess, which would be upsetting. If they play nothing next turn, we can still cartouche, although at this point we probably want to trial first, because then we can start getting more gas than just what we have. Let's see if they do anything for three. They sure do. They play a 3-3. But it can't block, so it's going to be attacking, I assume. That's fine. We have a 3-4 on turn five. And there's our land as well. So let's play out. Yeah, they're tapped out. So let's just play out trial pre-combat. That's fine. We'll see what it lets us do. Okay, and we have to discard a single card. So let's discard this island. We can play Trial of Ambition and Cartouche of Ambition next turn. So we make them sack a creature and then bounce both trials back to our hand. We're just going to attack for two as well. Yeah, this seems pretty sweet. I am very happy with our decisions here. Seems good. I just kind of assumed with all the cartouches and all the Kenrit Eternals that we would just only have Kenrit Eternals wearing the cartouches, but Aerial Guide is just as fine of a choice. All right, tapping three, four. Another one of these. I'm kidding, but if they want to. Tapping three, four, tapping four. For a carry-on creature, it's a 3/1 flyer, which means this cartouche is going to do some work for us. That's pretty awesome. Okay, they can attack for three. That's fine. They will or will not attack for three. They will. Okay. That's fine. See, now the problem is, and this is kind of the nature of the Trial of Ambition, is that when I play it, they could sack this Screecher because they don't know that we have Cartouche. I assume they're sacking this so that they think that they can block here, but they're going to be very upset. So I'm going to play the Trial of Ambition. They have to sack a creature. Hopefully they choose this 3/3. I assume they will. That's at least what I would do if I were in their position. It's a tough choice. I don't envy them, they do. That is fantastic for us. A little cartouche of ambition. Lots of things happen. That being one of them, and then the trials happen as well. So yes, all of that, please. We just win. Wow. Okay. I thought it was a sweet play, but I definitely didn't think it was worth just conceding over. All right. Well, I mean, I don't know about you, but I'm just gonna run this back. That was a sweet start. Well, I wasn't even super happy with our start, at least with our opening hand, to be honest. But it worked out with those trials. Double trial, triple cartouche is a little disgusting, especially because that was all from Amonkhet packs, of which we only saw, one of, at least, going around the table. So, all right. We have four lands. We have a three drop, and a four drop. Still not the best, but we will take it. Like I said, it's much better than mulliganing, so. And I might be jinxing it, but we haven't had any trouble finding blue. We were kind of afraid of that. There's a Dreadwanderer. That's cool. Banewit Punisher can straight up kill that. Just come down and kill it. All right, so let's play this and end our turn. See, the nice thing is if we play Gravedigger to return Banewit Punisher or something, returning the Gravedigger to our hand works out very nicely for us. I will take two. I cannot block with a swamp. So, and they end their turn. Well, we have a Kenrit Eternal. That's pretty sweet. On curve. So it just kind of looks like we always had it. That's nice. They don't know that next turn we're just going to kill their Dreadwanderer, so with the Banewit Punisher. All right. Let's see what they've got. They're going to combat. They're attacking for two, and I am happily taking two. That is fine. Kenrit Eternal wants to be attacking. That's why it has afflict. And they end their turn. Well, that's pretty good for me. Looks like they are either low on lands or they just misclicked or something. So I'm going to tap three, playing the Banewit Punisher. And getting rid of that. And then we ourselves can attack for two. Yes, please. Go to combat. Attack. Yes. And that'll be our turn. I actually honestly don't know what we do next turn. I guess if they play something threatening, they're not playing anything at all because they still don't have another land. That's a shame. I'll play a land and then I'm probably just not going to do anything. I mean, obviously I'm attacking, but I mean in terms of playing stuff, if I'm not being threatened, I'll just keep attacking them for four every turn. Gravedigger can do some cool stuff. If any of these guys die, we can bounce if we really have to save something. All right, they got a third land. They play a Blighted Bat. Yeah, that feels bad. I think I'm just going to bounce my Banewit Punisher back to my hand. Oh, that's the end phase. Yeah, I'm going to bounce the Banewit Punisher. I'm going to play a land, tap three, replay it, and kill the Blighted Bat as well. Then I can attack for two again. That's my turn, I guess. I think that was correct. I talked about shenanigans with like bouncing the Gravedigger after I played it to get two things back, but nothing's really going in our graveyard yet. If we have to, we can Oblivion and make them discard two cards. Because if they're going to be low on land, we want to kind of punish them for that as much as possible. Although I understand that it gets them closer to Dreadwanderer coming back because they need fewer cards in their hands, but still, getting rid of making them make tough choices about what cards to get rid of would benefit us if we really have to. So this is just a 2/2, and then it can become a 3/3 if another zombie comes out. That's fine. I could Lethal Sting it, I just don't know that I'm going to. I assume that's their turn. Do we draw anything? We do. We draw another Kenra Eternal. That's sweet. All right, let's play another land. We'll have six total. Let's actually go to combat and attack with both. I assume they're going to block the Bane Whip Punisher. And then we can just get it back with Gravedigger this turn and play Kenra Eternal as well. Yep. That's really sweet. That works for me. I will tap four for the Gravedigger to return that thing to my hand. Yes. And then I'll play Kenra Eternal for two. Yeah, this deck seems disgusting. Like the next creature they play, we can either Lethal Sting it or Bane Whip Punisher it. We don't even have to show them. Yeah, I assumed. That was a little mean. I liked my deck a lot, but that was a little mean. I'll be back in a second with round two, guys. Well, after round one, we are right back into it for round two. That was a pretty fast round one. I'm definitely not complaining about that. That is a very unfortunate hand. We are more prominently black. It is very likely that we would draw a black mana very soon, but I'm not going to risk that, so I will mulligan this hand. This is not much better. I'm going to keep it and see what we scry. We scry another land, which I will keep on top just in the hopes that if we don't draw a blue, we can at least get to Soul Stinger eventually. But that's a rough start. It's a rough start for us. Let's see what happens. They end their turn. We draw that swamp that we saw already, and we pass. If they play something, we can Trial of Ambition. That's not the worst idea in the world. What do they play? Yeah, Kenra Eternal. Definitely not bad. It doesn't have Eternalize or anything. As we know, I kind of like Kenra Eternals. I've taken quite a number of them, so let's just Trial of Ambition now and make them do what they've got to do. If we draw a blue next turn, we can curve right into Aerial Guide, which would be really sweet. But for now, our turn is over. Any land whatsoever, and we can have Soul Stinger on four. They have an Ifnir Deadlands. That could be scary. There's a Wretched Camel, so they have a desert. We did not draw a blue, or any land. We just need one for the Soul Stinger. Let's see what they've got for us. I mean, they're probably just going to attack us for two, which is unfortunate. And they can make us discard a card when this guy dies, but okay. Okay. Do they do anything this turn? It looks like they do. Yeah, they're thinking about something. Okay. They're tapping three for a Baleful Ahmet. That's a great card. Oh my god. That's a really good card. Are they killing this guy? Yeah, they are, so that we'd have to discard a card. What do we discard? I think that we discard the Scrounger of Souls. They don't know that we're part blue yet, and I don't want to discard the Aerial Guide, especially if we just draw a land next turn as well. So I'm going to say okay to that happening and discard the Scrounger. It's a five drop. We would need at least two more turns to play it. I'm not super upset about that. And we drew another one anyway. Well, that's rough. They're going to be gaining lots of life and dealing us lots of damage, which is super unfortunate. So we're just going to end our turn, go to theirs, and they're going to hit us for four and gain four life. That's rough. Not having lands does kind of suck. But we're not out of this game yet. Hey, another Kenra Eternal. I've heard having multiples of those is good. An Adorned Pouncer as well. Interesting. So Adorned Pouncer with Double Strike is real bad if we don't. Well, that's not the worst thing in the world. We can kill the Adorned Pouncer. They can get it back for five, so next turn they can. Just make it a 4-4. That would suck. We can Torment of Venom, but Torment of Venom is probably better used on the Baleful Amit. I think I would just put Splendid Agony, one on this guy, one on this guy, and I'll wait because the Splendid Agony is an instant, so I will wait until their turn and make them think that we have nothing because we almost don't have anything. They're going to go to combat. Let's let them attack. It's just going to be everybody. That makes sense. I'm going to Splendid Agony. One here, one here. Okay. And then tapping three. That might be telegraphing to them since I didn't put it on here that I've got something. Because if I draw one more mana at this point, I'm probably just playing Torment of Venom and killing that. What are they doing? Making something indestructible, which is what I feel like they're trying to do, will not save either of these. Well, this will live regardless, but it doesn't save this. If it's a 0-0, even if it's indestructible, it still dies. That's why minus one counters are really good against gods. Okay, but it's when it dies, you return it to the battlefield. Well, that's unfortunate. It happens. It is tapped, though, and we take five, and they gain four. This game is not looking good for us. Hey, we got a land. It's the fourth land. Torment of Venom is an instant, though. We're gonna take three next turn because we're gonna kill the Baleful Amit, and then they might just sacrifice something. I'm assuming they're just gonna either discard their last card or just lose three. At this point, I'm an idiot. They'll just lose three life. That's the end of our turn. We'll play the Torment of Venom. We could still win this, otherwise I would concede, but there's no need if we can battle back into this, which is definitely a possibility. It's not looking good, but we haven't lost yet. So let's Torment of Venom on the Baleful Amit and kill it. Okay. So it dies, and they lost three life, which is what we assumed would happen. I take three and go to six. If I draw another land, oh, that was first strike damage. If I draw another land, I can go to I can play Scrounger of Souls. Otherwise, it's going to be Soul Stinger. Okay. Because with Soul Stinger, if I put the counters on itself, it's two, so it would become a 2/3, which means it can actually block both of these really well. And if it somehow dies, it can kill one of them. So maybe it's still Soul Stinger. And then I'll just leave up a black just because. Yeah, we can somehow still win this. All right, that's it. That's our turn. We're at six, and there are 25, but six is not zero. They still can't kill him. Well, now they can make him unable to block. We still don't lose. We only take three, at least on board. That's fine. He can't attack or block. If we can kill him somehow, that would be cool. The other option, which I'm not super happy about, would be to Cartouche of Ambition on him, and then, well, I guess if I draw another land, I can Aerial Guide Cartouche of Ambition. I don't really want to do that either, but I could. Yeah, it's just another Aerial Guide, which kind of sucks for us. This 3/4 lifelinker can block and gain us some life. If they have another thing that makes us unable to block, then we would lose. The other thing I can do is I can Cartouche of Ambition on the Soul Stinger, giving a minus one counter to the Kenra Eternal, bouncing the Trial of Ambition, or maybe I just give it to this it bounces the Trial of Ambition, and then I just replay Trial, they're gonna have a 4-4, and I have no way of dealing with that, which is kind of unfortunate. I should probably save the Trial of Ambition for that. So maybe let me do Scrounger first and see what happens. Because, like I said, Scrounger blocks really well. Even if I mean, losing one here and then taking two means I lose. So I have to block the 1-1, which means they just eternalize it and make it a 4-4 double striker. But again, then Trial of Ambition Cartouche works really well if they don't play another creature, which I'm assuming they're going to have to leave the 5 mana up. Oh, okay. So they're not. Maybe they just don't attack this turn? Let's see. Like I said, if they have a way of making this unable to block or something, like with another Desert's Hold, then we just lose and we go to game two. Yeah, they Lethal Sting, they kill it. That's fine. So, oh, but they did have to kill that, so I take two, go to one. It's not the worst. Definitely not the worst. I'm not dead yet. It's not looking good, though. Can I draw a land? That would actually be really helpful. No, I drew another cartouche though. Let's put a cartouche on him and put a minus one counter on the pouncer. It's actually really funny. Bounce the trial back. Kill the pouncer. Yes. And end my turn. I don't think there's any hasters in white black, so I'm not dead yet. We can trial and cartouche next turn. They just end their turn? That seems interesting. Well, I can play two aerial guides this turn then. Chat message. If I can't finish this while you're at one life, LOL. All right, and then I'll play another aerial guide. Oh man, battling back from one life will be interesting, but it is not over yet. Eight available mana. They're just gonna bring back their Eternalized guy. Oh no, that's not what they're doing. They're gonna try to kill something? They're going to kill something. Yeah, they're going to kill one of the aerial guides. Okay, that's fine. I'm waiting to use my trial on one of your on your 4/4 when you bring it back. Okay. They have one card in hand. I don't have seven, although one more mana and I do, but I think I'm just going to leave this up and start attacking for two in the air. That's all I've got so far. All right, we'll attack. And yeah, that's it for now. I can bounce something to save it. They're cycling a desert. That's fine. They have six available, so they can embalm still, or eternalize, I should say. But they are going to end their turn. Darn it. I want to be drawing more gas. I have so many good things that I could be playing, and I'm just not getting them. All right. Oh, I'm silly. I could bounce my Soul Stinger back to my hand. That's something. Do I do that, though? It's not the worst idea in the world. I could be getting in for some more damage. It's an instant, so I'll wait. I'll at least if they don't do anything that necessitates me using it by the end of this turn, their turn, then I'll use it at the end of their turn. Okay, they go to combat and they end their turn. So, like I said, I'm going to bounce my soul back to my hand. Okay. Oh, I got a trial of knowledge too? Gross. Do I have eight? I don't. I have seven. I still think I play trial of knowledge. Let's do two and two. I don't know what I'm gonna draw. All right, so I'll trial of knowledge first. Hopefully, one of the ones that I draw, I will want to discard because I don't want to discard any of these. Come on. What's happening? Okay, so I'll discard a land. That's fine. Discard a land, play a land, and play Soul Stinger. Okay. I'm not killing my aerial guide, so I'll just put the counters on the Soul Stinger. And then I'll attack for two. They have two cards in hand. I could have made them discard them, but I'll be aware of that for next turn, depending on if they play anything. Okay, so they're cycling Stir the Sands to make a zombie. Did they not have six? I would have just played Stir the Sands. I mean, it's sure it's 3/2s against a flyer, but still. Okay. All right. Well, okay. Oh no. Do they have another zombie? Do I immediately lose? No, don't have another zombie. That'd be. Oh, it counts. It counts as a zombie. Nicely done. I'm gonna tell him. He's been talking to me. He got there. It happens. Very nice. All right, game two. That was interesting. I really don't think that that loss was anything more than mulliganing and having a bad hand, in terms of maybe needing to sideboard. They did have a Desert's Hold, but I was able to get past it with Consigns. So yeah. I don't think I made any mistakes, which is another easy way to lose. I think I just need a little bit more luck on my side. So, and that was only game one. So let's just win the next two in a row really quickly, like we did in round one. Okay. Yes, I'd like to play first. I'd also like to have a playable hand. Both of those things happen for me. I like it. I will play a land and end my turn. Hopefully they do the same. If near Deadlands, very nice start. Worked out well for him last time. All right. Whoops, that's not what I wanted. That's what I wanted. Kenra Eternal, please. I will end my turn. Oh, they lost one life. Oh, it's a Wayward Servant. Okay. Trial of Ambition's gonna make you get rid of that guy, though. Sorry. He was very bad for me last game. So I don't want it. Trial of Ambition it is. All right, let's attack. Much earlier this game than last game. Okay. So next turn I'll have four, so I can either cartouche or aerial guide. It has lifelink. If I cartouche, then I'll have trial back in my hand. I was going to say it also depends on what I draw, but do I? Maybe I attack. They'll gain three and go back to 20, but they'll lose one, so they'll actually go to 19. But they don't know I have another Kenra Eternal, so if they don't block, then that's fine. I'll just play the other Kenra Eternal. Yeah, that's fine. Play a land. Maybe I play Aerial Guide instead. Putting Cartouche on Aerial Guide seems really good. Plus, getting my Kenra Eternal to fly over the top of this guy also seems pretty good. I'll take three. I'll have ways of getting rid of that, either with minus one counters or other things later. Okay, Aerial Guide cannot attack or block. And what do they gain? Three life? Yeah, they gain three life. So they go to 18. Very nice. Very, very nice. And they gain another three and go to 21, and I go to 17. That also happens. And that's their turn. I drew a Soul Stinger. Card has seemed good for me. Let's go to combat first. Just in case. I don't think their Ifnir Deadlands is going to be playing anything for them, but still, we can go to attacks. Okay. Let's play the Soul Stinger out. Maybe I just kill my aerial guide and have a 4/5. That seems fine, right? I know I could bounce aerial guide, but I don't have that card yet, and the bounce card, and I have another aerial guide, so I'll probably just do that. Make my creatures more efficient here. Plus, it kind of prevents that camel from attacking. I mean, he could have tricks or something, but I'm not super worried about it right now. Plus, putting a cartouche on a Soul Stinger with no minus one counters on it seems fun. We'll see. Five mana gets you a final reward, exiling it. Very, very nice. I almost took one of those. And then I take three, and you gain three. They're winning this race. Till I play the Scrounger of Souls, that is. A lethal sting. Okay, and it's a sorcery, so I'd have to do it on my turn. So why not? If I had drawn another land on any of these turns, I could have cartouche and trialed in the same turn. But I think I'm just going to attack and then lethal sting post combat, I guess. Yeah, I want to put a stop to this thing earlier rather than later. So I'll destroy that, paying three, and putting the counter on the Kenra. All right, that's my turn. They have five. None of these have Eternalize or anything for them to bring back. Now they have six mana, three cards in hand. Ruin Rat. Well, Cartouche of Ambition is really good right now. Plus, it'll let my trial just be in my hand, and now I draw the land. Very nice. So I can Cartouche and Kenra, which is cool. Let's Cartouche. Kill the rat. Okay. Yes, please. It dies. They get to exile something from my graveyard. That doesn't matter. I assume it's the aerial guide, but. Oh, yeah. It does matter if I have Gravedigger. Oh, no. They haven't seen Gravedigger yet, I guess, because they picked Lethal Sting. All right. That's good for me. And then I will play the Kenra Eternal and attack. Okay. Their turn. Can play Scrounger next turn as well. Oh. So they'll kill this guy. That's fine. Both times they've had to sack the Deadlands, even though we saw that they did have a white desert as well. Kefnet's last word is not something I want to do here, so let's go to combat first. Yes, no, maybe. Attack for two. Yes. And then play a better lifelinker than the one they just killed. Yeah, Kefnet's last word is just almost not happening. If I need it to get the last couple of points of damage in, if they have like one blocker or something, I can do that. Or if they play something insane that we just haven't seen yet, then that's more or less what this is for. I'm not just gonna play it on, like a solitary camel, for example. And if that's the only card they're playing, oh, it's not. Do they have two? That would be a flavor fail. They have Lethal Sting. So they'll kill my 3/4, very nice. And they have a 2/1 camel, which is gonna die to a Trial of Ambition. We have a Bane Whip Punisher. Actually, that's even better. So I will play the Bane Whip Punisher instead, putting the counter on this, killing it, and then just having a Bane Whip Punisher. And then I can attack for two. Yes, I will use its ability. The battle of the removal decks. They're exiling stuff of mine, killing stuff of mine. I'm doing the same to them. This is fun. No need for Trial of Ambition, so that's my turn. Okay. They have a Kenra Eternal. Very nice. They also have a Lurching Rot Beast. Also very nice. I would probably just. Wow. All right. So I guess I'll Trial of Ambition. Make them pick. I assume it's the actually, I don't know. Right. Trial of Ambition happens. They are sacrificing. I actually don't know. I really, really don't know. I might get rid of the 4/2. I genuinely have no idea. Yeah, that's as good as anything, really. I'll play Cartouche. I'm gonna put it on the Kenra. Bouncing the trial. I'm giving a minus one to the Lurching Rot Beast. And then, yes, I'll use the ability. And I probably don't attack this turn, which is unfortunate. But since they can just kill anything, and I can just sack the Bane Whip Punisher next turn to kill it, and then Trial of Ambition to kill anything else that they play, I don't care if I take three next turn, because if they attack, I'm not blocking either. I can risk going to 13. Let's see what they play. Another Kenra Eternal. Yeah, our decks are very similar. I just have blue and they have white, really. It's a free three and it's gonna die anyway, so you might as well. Because I didn't attack because I clearly don't want either of these guys to die to it, So you'll get. Nope. Okay. That's fine. They don't know that, obviously, but still. All right. So I'm going to tap a black and use this to kill that guy. And then replay trial. And then attack for 3 lifelink. Yeah, this is working out very well. And like I said, I've still got what a great backup card in Kefnet's Last Word, just sitting there waiting for something to steal. Liliana's defeat. Wow. What a sideboard. That sucks. Okay. That happens. You have 5 mana left, but no cards in hand. And we just got to a board stall with all this. Oh man, that sucks. That is real bad. Well, we're both top decking, that's for sure. I don't have anything that I can bring back or use or anything. They played a land, so they're done too. All right, what do we got? A cartouche, that's not helpful, although it would bounce our trial. That's funny. Now it's just a fight of who draws a creature first. They're playing something. Wow. They're playing something big. Stir the Sands. Wow, very nice. Good for them. Nice draw. Kefnet's Last Word does not help there, and we just drew another land. So we're just gonna take 6 this turn? That really sucks. Gravedigger is something that would be really helpful to draw now, because I could draw it and then get like the Bane Whip Punisher back or something, or maybe Scrounger of Souls would probably be better. Yeah, I take 6. We were both in top deck mode, and I'm not using Kefnet's Last Word to steal a zombie token. They cycle to draw. They have 4 or 5 left, excuse me. And they play a Wretched Camel. I don't have a desert, so stealing it doesn't do anything for us. They have no cards in hand. I could bounce one of their zombies. That would be okay, I guess. I have nothing else going on. And then if for some reason they're hoarding cards in their hand later on, I can make them discard it. They go to combat, and they just swing out. I mean, it makes sense. I'm still gonna take 6, but I can bounce one of their tokens and take 6. Wow. Hey, it's something I can play. All right. So we Bane Whip Punisher on a zombie token, Cartouche of Ambition on the Bane Whip Punisher, putting the -1/-1 counter on a zombie token, the same zombie token, I should say. And then replay Trial of Ambition and see which one they choose. Can we do it all in one turn? We absolutely can, yeah. That's crazy. That's really funny. They're doing something. Oh my god. Oh, okay. I was like, what are they doing? It's a lot of mana they just tapped. It was like 5? 1, 2, 3, 4. And then not. Oh, okay. Yes, I'll use the ability. Okay. I don't know what they were tapping there. It kind of makes me want to make them discard that card, but I'd rather just do what I was going to do in the first place. Oh God, what are they doing? Now they're going to kill it, I assume. Yeah. Torment of Venom. That's fine. It happens. That's a damn shame. But it should still be okay. I'm not discarding. Do I lose 3 life here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Bane what Punisher's dying, so I have nothing left on board. If I take three, or lose three, I go to four. Do I have to sack my trial? Do I have... That's all three of my cartouches, so I can't get trial back regardless, so I'll sack trial. Okay. So cartouche tries to happen and fails. I can't play Kefnet's Last Word, and I'm gonna take five and go to two on my next turn, or on their turn right now. I'll be at two. I fought back from one pretty hard, so let's see what happens. If I Kefnet's Last Word on something, unless it's what they play, oh god, they played nothing, so I just lose now? I just lose now. Wow. That was crazy. What a crazy game. I can make them discard the one card in their hand for five. So I'll play a land. I have nine, so I can do both. And I think I will. I'll make them discard two cards. Okay, and they discarded... What did they discard? A swamp. Great. Well, good for them. I will then play Kefnet's Last Word on their zombie, I guess. And then tell them good games. Because they've got it. They win. And I will pass. That was rough. Game one was rough. Game two was fantastic, though. I loved this. It happens. It was tapped when I stole it. It stays tapped, and I take three. End of game. Good stuff. Very, very good stuff. Do I not get to see the message? That's interesting. As it was after the fact. Oh, well. All right, I'll be back with round three in just a sec, guys. Well, we cannot go undefeated and get a trophy this time. And with this hand, look at this hand. With this hand, we probably won't be even going 2-1, which is super unfortunate. But I will mulligan. And this is really also bad. I'm going to keep it, though, because I don't... Well, that's a crappy top card. Sure, if I draw blue in the next four turns, I can play that. That is unfortunate. It's a desert. It comes into play tapped, and that's the end of their turn. I will play a land and end my turn as well. They play a Doom Dissenter, and we get a Gravedigger. Not a terrible card, but not the first creature you want to play in a game. That's it for us. Doom Dissenter is going to be dealing some damage if they send it out, which they should. Black-green is a good archetype. It's one of my favorites. Putting a -1/-1 counter on Doom Dissenter feels kind of nice. But not if you're under no pressure to do so. They get a Hooded Brawler. Hey, we get a Kenra Eternal. That's not the worst. We'll play it. If it dies, we can Gravedigger it back. Using Cartouche on Hooded Brawler seems good for us so that we can then attack, but they presumably would just block with their Doom Dissenter so they could just get a zombie out of it, but we'll see. Torment of Venom is not a terrible card to play on Hooded Brawler either. I was going to say, I'd block Doom Dissenter. I will not block Hooded Brawler, exerted or not. It is exerted, so I will take 5 and go to 14. It's exerted, so we have another turn on Torment of Venom. Hopefully they play something that Cartouche would benefit from being used on. Yep. As long as it puts it, and it could put it on the Doom Dissenter and just have a 4/4. Yep, that's what they do. That's fine. That's unfortunate though, because putting individual minus one counters on this guy is a really bad idea. It's kind of doesn't do anything for us. Well, we don't have any blue for either of these four drop blue cards. Now, if I attack and they block with their. If they block with their zombie, then I'm a little upset because trading a 2/2 for half a card is not good. But if they block with their 4/4 so that they keep their zombie, then I can Torment of Venom and kill the 4/4. I don't know that that's really worth it, but because they can just get us at that point, that's really rough. Because then they'll just remove, if we Torment of Venom and this hasn't taken damage, then they'll just attack with it, make it a 2/2, and gain a life off of it, and then just keep doing that. So, what we could do is Cartouche on it, and then attack, so that then if they block with this, we just get to eat it, and if they block with this, it's a trade, which I'm okay with because of Gravedigger. But if not, like I said, the next turn they're just attacking with a 4/4. They'll take three and be happy about it. And we just have no way then of getting rid of this guy. God, I'm gonna stop thinking about it. I'm gonna try that. It's the best I've got, at least for now. And I'm gonna put the counter on the exemplar, and then I'm going to attack. And hope that they trade. Because I don't care if they trade. Although I assume they don't care if they take three. They are blocking. Wow, they did it! Oh, thank God. That's awesome. That's just awesome. Because the Hooded Brawler is still exerted, so I don't care about that. That's fantastic. Whew! Now I'm upset that I thought about it for so long. Sorry, guys. They only have three lands, although they're playing stuff with them, so that's something. I'll take two. Go to 15. And I assume that's their turn. And it sure is. Okay. Still no blue, huh? Damn. That sucks. All right. Let's. Gravedigger, I guess? Bring back the Kenra Eternal. It's the only option. Yes, please. And that's my whole turn. This is a lackluster hand. It's pretty unfortunate. Okay. They go to combat. If they don't exert the brawler, then I trade for it, but they do, so clearly I won't. Do I trade for the zombie token, though? Otherwise, I take seven and go to eight, so yeah, I guess I block like that. Very good. I'm at 10 and they're at 19. They had another desert. That's something. I have another Torment of Venom. All right. Well, it's an instant, so I will wait. If they play something that's more relevant for me to use it on, I can use it on that. instead of on the Hooded Brawler, but the Hooded Brawler is not a threat to me. I'm just going to take one damage this turn on board. So, yeah. Let's see what they've got. They still don't know we're blue yet. This is game one, so. Alright, they have four for a Carrion Screecher. Well, that's fine, I guess. I'll take one. At the end of their turn, I will Torment of Venom on the Hooded Brawler. Because I don't have anything with haste, so it doesn't matter as much with the Carrion Screecher. I'm assuming they just. Oh no, they lost three. Okay. I don't know why they wouldn't sack the Doom Dissenter. It counts as it dying. Banewit Punisher was a really nice draw there. Wow. Really, really nice. Yeah, let's put that minus one counter on that Carrion Screecher. Very, very nice. That's really good for us. Yes, please. And that's my turn. Drawing some blue would be nice. I mean, we still got stuff to do if we don't, but man, would some blue mana be sweet. Soul Stinger. Okay. Torment of Venom kills him too. Oh, actually, Banewit Punisher kills him. Like right now. Do I do that? I think I can do that. Why not? Cool. He's dead. And he doesn't get to put his counters on anything. Oh, he can't put him on the Doom Dissenter. Okay. Good. There's a Trial of Ambition. I don't want to do that yet. Let's Kenra Eternal. It's a good counter to a 1/1 that even if it wants to die. If they play only one thing, we probably just attack, let them block, and then I don't know. Trial of Ambition still might make them. They might just pick the zombie anyway. We'll see. They have five. Okay, they have a 3/4 lifelinker. We can make it an 0/1. Yeah. We have another Kenra Eternal. Let's attack and see what they do. If they block with the 3/4, we can just Torment of Venom on it. And they'll lose one life on the block anyway, which is nice for us. They block. Okay, so Afflict 1 happens. Let's Torment of Venom then. Cool. And let's see what they choose to do with Torment of Venom. They choose to sack the Doom Dissenter. That makes sense. And we eat their 0/1. They gain no life off lifelink. But they lost one for blocking. And that's the end of our turn. That was an interesting turn. We're at 9, they're at 15. We could go to 7 if they attack. We still don't have any blue. Blue would be real nice right now. They attack all five for an Archfiend of Ifnir. That's a pretty good card. If we can find a way to get rid of this zombie, though, we can make him sack it. Can we find a way to get rid of this zombie? I take two. We found a blue mana. That's not nothing, but we risk taking. If they cycle two things, this dies. So we might just need to play Naga Oracle to make sure that it lives. We can fix our draws a little bit. I mean, we can just Trial of Knowledge as well and draw that stuff back, but I don't really want to throw out Aerial Guide, because again, if they can cycle two things, they only have two cards in hand, but if they can cycle two things, then we just lose both of our creatures and then lose. Is it only my creatures? Yeah. So, and then we just lose from taking seven. So I'm gonna play a little bit more defensively and play a Naga Oracle. and hope that its ability will let me get some good stuff. What do I get? Ugh, I can put any number into my graveyard and the rest back on top in any order. Can I just put all of these in my graveyard? Pick any number and put them into my graveyard. I think all of them. This is not what I want. I have five, so I can play both of these or an aerial guide in one of these next turn. So yeah, I think all of these go to my graveyard. That was terrible. All right, I'm not attacking. I'd rather have blockers back. Maybe I do attack. No, because they just kill it with the Archfiend. All right. I want to kill the zombie. I want the Archfiend to be the only card left on their field, or only creature, I should say, so that this trial can do some work. They are going to attack for at least five. It is only five. I go to two. Up. Well, fine. Then we go to game two, I guess. Okay, game two it is. Archfiend of Ifnir is real good, and I like it. Do we do anything different? Again, we kind of got screwed over with our lands and our draws, and mulliganing. I still think the deck is fine. Do we have anything against that? We have that counterspell, but I don't think that's what we need to be doing right now. We have that other Scrounger of Souls. Yeah, I don't see any specific flyer hate. Yeah. So yeah, that's gonna be our deck. We'll just bring it back. See what happens. I would like to play first. Yes, that is definitely the case. Two lands is crappy. Definitely crappy. A little tired of that, but I'm keeping it anyway because any land gets us Cartouche as well. Yeah, they kept seven as well, which is the other reason why. And we will end our turn, and we'll just get a Kenra Eternal on turn two. Let's see what happens. Do they play something? They don't. That's just their turn now. Okay. On my turn, I will play. Hey, I drew a land. I'll play a Kenra Eternal. And it's a second blue, not a second black yet. So we can't Torment of Venom as of yet. We can Kefnet's Last Word. I mean, technically, can't do either until we draw a land, but if it's another blue, we can Kefnet's Last Word. If it's another black, it's Torment of Venom. For right now, it's just attacking with the Kenra Eternal, and ending my, well, playing a land and ending my turn, because I'm not gonna cartouche on it and waste the possibility of a minus one counter. Okay, do they end their turn now as well? Or can they play something for two? They cannot. At least it doesn't look like it. Nope. Okay. We drew a fourth land. And we can play a Soul Stinger. Question is, do we put the counters on itself? I think we do. Maybe we don't. Because we can cartouche on this guy, make him a 5/6, but they have ways of killing stuff, so yeah, I'll put it on itself. Right. That's fine. Goes on itself. And then we attack for two. Yes. That way, please. All right. That's our turn as well. The land situation was a lot better, or has been a lot better this time. Still nothing to Kefnet's Last Word with. They got a fourth land. They're doing something. Soul Stinger. Hey, look at that. Okay. It's a 2/3. Well, we can. That's actually a really interesting question. They have six cards in hand, so I don't think it's worth it to Kefnet's last word. Although, yeah, and we have trial. So we can trial, and then they'll just sack this, put two counters on either one of these. They can either kill the Eternal or make the Soul Stinger an 0-1, and then I'll be able to cartouche later and get the trial back. That's a tough one. And if I attack, nothing happens. They'll just, these things bounce off each other. This would die. So I think I'm gonna trial here, because either way, Kenra's dead. So let's just trial. Make them do that before attacks, so they can't just block and make it easier on themselves. And do they shrink the Soul Stinger or kill the Kenra? I think I'd kill the Kenra. It's got afflict. Yep, that's what they do. That's fine. And then I attack for two. Okay. That all happens, and that's my turn. They have five available with, well, five mana and six cards in hand. And they do with it. Two mana, three, four, five, all of it, for a Scrounger of Souls. Okay, very nice. Very, very nice. I drew a land. I can cartouche trial, one right after the other, and gain some life, or I can attack, and when they block, Torment of Venom. Or they might not even block, so maybe I just cartouche trial here. Or maybe I Kefnet's last word here. Ugh, no. I will cartouche. I waste the counter a little because I'm just going to make them sack it in a second, but that's fine. Yes. And then I'll just replay the trial, make them sack their only creature, and then attack for three and gain three life. Okay. And I still have Scrounger of Souls as backup, or Kefnet's Last Word if they play something crazy. Like the Archfiend of Ifnir. That would be a really nice target for Kefnet's Last Word. They have a 2-1 that would make me discard a card, which, depending on what I draw, would probably not be a big deal. Oh, okay. So they're destroying my Soul Stinger. Maybe I just get rid of Torment of Venom. I think at this point, unfortunately, that's got to be the pick, because this is my only creature right now. So, and Kefnet's Last Word could still be helpful. They are part green, so they could do like pretty scary stuff. Plus, we've already seen the Archfiend, like I said. So, let's play our own Scrounger of Souls. And end our turn. Let's see. They have six now. Seven. It's a lot of mana. And three cards in hand. Ah, Bitter Bow Sharpshooters. Actually, I like that card a lot. Let's see. Do they end their turn? They do. Ooh, interesting. Okay, so I can attack. They block, and then we Torment of Venom it. I could also just steal it. They're at 11? Yeah, I mean, I'd gain three life off the block, and it would die from that, and then they would either lose three or discard a card because they can't sack something. So, yeah, I think I'll do that. Let's attack. Attack for three lifelink. If they don't block, we can just Torment of Venom on their turn or bounce it. No, they block. Okay. Let's Torment. It becomes a 1-1. And then they have to choose. They lose 3 life. Fantastic. And then their creature dies and we gain 3 life. It's pretty sweet. That's the end of our turn. That works. Hopefully we're going to game 3 here. We'll see. That's 5. It's Archfiend. Thank you, Kefnet's Last Word. God, that's awesome. I was like, what are the chances they'll draw it? I should probably play it on something. I felt like I was like not doing the right thing by not playing it, but I'm gonna go ahead and steal this guy. Thank you, Kefnet's Last Word. Thank you. They're tapping 2 to cycle something, I assume? Yep. That's fine. My lifelinker becomes a 2/3, but I still get your creature permanently. And then I will gain some life and take you to 6. Okay. That's pretty awesome. They have 7 left. Or 7 left. They have 7 available, and they'll play a 3/3. And a Hooded Brawler. Very nice. Okay, what do I draw? A Kenra Eternal. All right, I'll put my lands on tap. We talked about this. That's fine. I will attack with the Archfiend because I am at a life total where even if they crack back as hard as they can, I will still only go back to my starting life total unless they have pump of some kind, which we did see them have some, but they'll go to 1, and I have a flyer, their flyer, to be specific. Yep, okay, so we go to game 3. That was much better. That's what Kefnet's Last Word is in this deck for, are things that are insane that we kind of can't deal with. So thank you, Kefnet's Last Word. Very important. Do we put anything different in? I know I asked this question before as well, and I still think that the answer is no. So, let's go to game 3 and hope that the card drawing gods are on our side, because they sure have not been. Ugh. Come on, man. That sucks. I honestly don't even know that I can keep this hand. I have no creatures. I have no promise that I'll get up to 4. And I only have 2 lands, so I'm gonna mulligan. This hand I will keep. That's much better. Kefnet's Last Word on top? Ugh, against this opponent? I think I have to keep it on top, don't I? Ugh. If I put it on the bottom, I'll just never see it, and I will it'll be a lot tougher to combat the 5/4, the Archfiend, but not impossible. So that'll be it for me. And now I can play the Eternal and end my turn. And then it's their turn. And they play a Banewit Punisher. It's a good card. Very good card. Okay, yeah, if I leave this up, I can bounce it when they sack the Banewit Punisher, so that's something. I probably don't attack. Yeah, I don't attack. I want them to use the ability, but I don't think they will. They got a green. They are just gonna attack me. Makes sense. No blocks. I'm gonna 18. Okay. And then they play a carrion screecher. Well, unfortunately, well, no, they don't have the mana for it right now. I was gonna say, unfortunately, if I play this, but yeah, no, they can totally do that. The unfortunate thing is that when it goes back to their turn, they just undoubtedly kill this because it's a 2-for-1, but we've already killed this with it, so it's really a 2-for-2. Torment of Venom would get rid of that as well, but we can't do both. So I think we just cartouche. Feels bad to do this, but I think I'm going to. And then I can attack, get in for 2 and gain 2 life, and just kill their 3-1, which is really the most important part of this decision. So yeah. We'll swap life totals. They'll go to 18, we'll go to 20, and then we end our turn. Like I said, I assume that this just gets sacrificed to kill this. Although they do have 5, so they could just play Archfiend, but that's what Kefnet's last word is for. Yep, we'll take 2. And then, oh my God, please tell me they're playing it right now. Yes! Oh my God. That feels really nice. That's hilarious. All right, so no single mana will help us here, so it doesn't matter which one I play, but I'm going to. I'm so glad I kept that on top. Let's go to combat. That's disgusting. And I'll attack for 2, gain 2 life. And that's my turn. Can they kill their own Archfiend? They probably can. There's plenty of ways. And if they can get one minus one minus one counter on it, the Bane Whip Punisher can kill it. But a Bitterbow Sharpshooters. Okay. Well, that's one way of doing it. But I can do the same thing I did last time and attack. In fact, let's do that. Oh no, I can't. Not this turn. This turn, I will just end. I will not end my turn. I will play at least an island to be able to play this. So let's do that because this can bounce something, either one of theirs or one of mine, to save it. Because the nice thing is, if they attack with this guy, I can block with the flyer and then just bounce the vigilance. I don't want to bounce the Archfiend because they'll get it back. I have to discard 2 cards. Okay, I will discard. That's a very interesting choice. So I will discard the Kenra and the Consign to Oblivion and keep the Torment of Venom because it's much more important. So I'll discard the. And that just means that we don't get to do bounce shenanigans, but that's fine. If I take some damage this turn, I take some damage. Hey, look! I discarded 2 cards. Thanks, buddy. They're just gonna kill that before it dies. That's fine. And then their 4/4s become a 2/2. Sweet. Thanks for making me discard cards. Okay. I could do this, but I'm not going to. They have 3 cards in hand, but still. I have 6 mana available. I'm going to attack and see what happens. Because they can have that +2/+2 spell. And then I can just Torment the Venom it. So let's see what happens. I will go to attacks. And attack. They do not block, which is nice for me. And then I will play a Soul Stinger, putting the counters on itself. All right, that's it for me. Yeah, Torment of Venom is going to be really nice here. Anything that they like, this guy's way too small now, but anything that they play, like an Obelisk Spider is a really good card, would definitely do well. Okay, Harrier Naga, that's fine. Obelisk Fighter is great. I love that card so much. There are no attacks, and it's my turn. I got a cartouche. On this guy, seems good. This will not be dealing combat damage, so I can, if I give it a minus one counter. So why don't we do that on the Archfiend? Tapping three and putting the minus one counter on the Obelisk Spider. Because the spider's ability only activates if they put the minus one counters. So then I will attack with just the flyer, because their 3/3 can eat my Soul Stinger. Do they block? They have two viable blockers. They will block and chump. That's fine. I'm at 26, they're at 11. It's. Game's definitely not over yet. We saw that earlier, but still, it's looking pretty good for us so far. Three mana. To play Doomfall. Okay. I exile a creature I control. It's gonna be the Soul Stinger. It's gonna be the Soul Stinger. Hooded Brawler. That's fine. And again, sweet Torment of Venom target. If we have nothing else to do, it's not a bad idea. I'll take three. Nope, not attacking? Okay. Kenrit Eternal seems fine. Do we do that? No, let's attack first. Attacks first, please. We can Torment of Venom to save some. Save this if we have to. We don't. They're just chumping again. Okay. And then we Kenrit Eternal. And end our turn because Torment of Venom is an instant. And if they exert this, then with the exert ability on the stack, we kill it with Torment of Venom. Even though we're at 32, so it doesn't really matter, we're still just gonna do it. They have one card in hand? Yeah. Let's do it with the ability on the stack. And we'll make them make that tough decision of whether to lose three life or sack their other creature or discard their last card. They choose to lose three. That seems great for us. Okay. They play their last card. It's a Scrounger of Souls. All right. They can start getting in for some damage. Hey, another Kenrit Eternal. Sweet. All right, let's attack. They take six, we gain six. They have no cards in hand, so they have no way of stopping that for this turn. I could have attacked. But I didn't, and that's fine. They didn't know we had the other Kenrit Eternal. And so now we're in a pretty sweet position, I feel like. We can make them, if they keep a card in hand, we can make them discard it. They're attacking for three, so they gain three life, but that's not enough. So it depends on what they drew. I'm not blocking, there's no need. That's fine. It's 35 to 5. They're playing their card. It's a 3/3 that can't block because they don't have another zombie. And that's the game. Well, guys, we actually went 2-1. That's pretty sweet. I said I would figure out this format eventually, and I kind of did. So, thank you guys so much for watching. I really, really hope that you enjoyed it. Please let me know what you thought of the deck in the comments down below. Please feel free to critique my playstyle. I'm totally okay with that. That's why I do this, is because I'm willing to have that happen. There are going to be videos popping up on the screen. Please feel free to click those. Some playlists of videos that we have on this channel, other drafts, product openings, story reviews, things like that. And if you click on our logo when it pops up on the screen, you can click that to subscribe to our channel, and you can find out when all of these videos come out. We put out three videos a week for all of you. We really hope that you enjoyed. Thank you guys so much for watching. I've been Joe. This is Geek for All. And as we always say, in whichever video of ours you watch next, we will see you all next time. Thanks so much, everybody.